Because I'm a big fan of Japan and its culture, and we all know that when geishas are treated like celebrities over there, not when they're walking on the street, people just flock and take pictures with them. They go through some serious training to entertain these men. I don't think it would be right to compare the two. That's part of the Japanese culture. Escorts came about, and I don't know when, but I can't say it's part of the Filipino culture or any other country's culture. It was brought about, that's what we also tackle in this movie, that especially here in the Philippines, that some of these men, women who engage in this industry are forced into it by hardship of life. To be a geisha, it's either your choice. I think they choose to be a geisha. I'm not too sure, but from what I read, I know that they choose to be that, and it's something to be proud of. It's really hard for me to talk about this because I don't want to put escorts down. Like I said, most of them enter this business because kailangan nila pera, kailangan nila mabuhay. But of course, there are still those that just enter because they want to make quick money overnight. And those are the ones that actually make that business look bad or make escorts look bad. The ones that wala nang pride sa sarili ba na parang ibigay na nila yung katawan nila because they didn't make so much money. They let money dictate their life. And you'll see women like that also in our movie. But you'll also see the other side of escorts that do it because kailangan makatapos na college,